Hey children, welcome back to YouTube Learning once again. So in the last video we have learned about interconversion of potential and kinetic energies by taking simple pendulum as the example, right? So what happens then in a simple pendulum? When the simple pendulum is at rest, when it is in mean position, the bob of the pendulum will be at rest and the simple pendulum will have minimum potential energy but maximum kinetic energy. Suppose when I take the bob to the position B and C, then what happened? When I took the position of the bob on either side, when it was at the mean position, it is at mean position, then I will move the bob to any one side. From here I will release the bob. Here the bob has attained maximum height and hence it will have maximum potential energy and kinetic energy will be zero because the bob is at rest. When I release the bob moves towards this position and here the height of the bob is very less, so potential energy will be zero and it will have maximum kinetic energy. Likewise, when the bob moves to the other side, then once again what happens? The potential energy will be maximum and kinetic energy will be zero. Always remember that there will be interconversion of potential energy and kinetic energy when the body which is at rest starts moving. Okay. Now even if you take water stored in a dam, the water stored in a dam will have potential energy because it is at rest. When the same water starts flowing, then the potential energy gradually changes to kinetic energy. Okay. Now in this video we shall learn about the various forms of energy and how we are using the various forms of energy and transforming into the other forms of energy. So which are the various forms of energy? Light, heat, sound, mechanical, electrical, magnetic, chemical and nuclear. Now why I call all these as energy? What is energy? Energy is the capacity to do work, right? Capacity to do work. So energy is the capacity to do work and heat is having the capacity to do work, light is having the capacity to do work, likewise all other forms are also having the capacity to do work. Now for example, if you take heat energy, how heat energy is capable of doing work? See, when you are using a pressure cooker at home, what you are doing? You are heating the pressure cooker and once you are supplying heat energy, then what happens due to that heat energy, the whistle which is there on the lid of the cooker will go up, is it not? It will move the whistle up upwards, that mechanically you can also lift it, but instead of doing mechanically, the heat energy is doing the work here, is it not? So you can conclude that heat is a form of energy. If you take the example of a steam engine, there also what is happening, we are using the heat energy from the coal and that heat energy is used to run the engine. It is used to run the engine. So here also we can conclude that heat is also a form of energy. So based on this only, James Watt designed the first steam engine where he used the heat energy and made the engine to run. Understood? Now, light is a form of energy. You might have studied that whenever the comet nears the sun, comets, you have heard about comets? When the comet is revolving around the sun, what happens? On some occasions, this is the sun, the comet will be traveling like this. When the comet comes near the sun, what happens? Due to the light of the sun, whatever dust particles will be there in the comet, it will be moved outwards. And it is observed as tail for us. We have studied that a comet will have a head and a tail. Now, a comet usually will be circular in shape, but when the tail is developed, when the light of the sun makes the dust particles in the comet move outwards. So, here we can tell that light, intense beam of light, can move the dust particles. Understood? So, light is doing some work, so light can be considered as a form of energy. And the sound energy, whenever sound is incident on our ears, then what happens? It will vibrate the eardrums, is it not? So that is also a work which is done by the sound. So sound can be calculated as form of energy. Likewise, the previous classes we have learnt about mechanical energy. Mechanical energy consists of both potential and kinetic energies. Is it not? Okay. Then electrical energy. Are we able to do any work using electrical energy? Yes. Every day we are using electrical energy only for various purposes. For cooking, is it not? For washing, for grinding, for lifting water, we are using electrical energy only. Magnetic energy. Yes. Magnets have the power to pull iron pieces or some other magnetic substances towards each side. So that is mainly due to the energy, magnetic energy. Next, nuclear energy, chemical energy. Chemical energy, we are using batteries, right? In that energy is stored in the form of chemical energy. That chemical energy is used to light the bulbs and all, is it not? In a torch, when you put a battery in a cell, then the chemical energy which is present in the cell will be converted into electrical energy and the bulb will glow. So we can conclude that even chemical energy is a form of energy. Likewise, nuclear energy. The energy which is present in the nucleus of an atom, that energy is used. That is called nuclear energy, and we are using nuclear energy and producing electricity. So all these forms of energies are capable of doing work. Understood? Now, apart from that, you can convert one form of energy to the other form of energy. In my previous video, what I have told, the whatever energy is present in this system, in this universe, the entire energy remains constant. You cannot destroy the existing energy nor create any new energy. But what you can do, you can only convert energy from one form to the other form. Okay, so if you just observe your textbook, here he has listed out energy transformation in common daily situations. So in our daily life, we are using various forms of energy and we are converting energy from one form to the other form. Now where we are using, see, suppose we are using a drill to drill a hole, drilling machine you have seen, to drill a hole in the wall, what you are doing, you are using electrical energy. And by using electrical energy, you are able to make hole in the wall. Electrical energy is being converted into mechanical energy. So we are transforming energy from one form to the other form, right? And one more thing I told you, in hydroelectricity generation project, hydro power plants will be there, no? There what they will do, they will store water at a higher level. Water is stored at a higher level, and this water is made to run the turbine. Turbine means it will be a very giant wheel with the teeth that when the water at a great pressure falls on the turbine, this water. Initially this water will have potential energy, and the same water starts moving, it will be converted into kinetic energy. Because of the kinetic energy of the water, the turbine starts rotating. So we will get mechanical energy. And this turbine is connected to a dynamo device called dynamo. This dynamo will convert mechanical energy into electrical energy. See here, how many energy changes are taking place in a hydroelectric process. Potential energy of water to kinetic energy of water, then to mechanical energy of the turbine, and then to dynamo, then to electrical. So here we are converting mechanical energy of the turbine to electrical energy. Even when you rub the two stones, then what will happen due to friction? Light energy is produced, heat energy is produced. You are mechanically rubbing. So mechanical energy, your muscular energy you are applying, and you are rubbing the stones, and you are able to convert that energy into heat energy and light energy. Right? Likewise, you see, interconversion of heat energy. Whether the heat energy is used to do any work? Yes. You take petrol engine, diesel engine and all, they what we are doing? We are burning petrol and diesel. When we burn the petrol and diesel, lot of heat energy is released. That heat energy will run the engine. Right? Even if you take steam engine, there also we are burning coal. Then it is converted into heat energy of water. That water is converted to steam, and that steam will run the turbine. is it not? That steam will run the piston of the cylinder in the engine, and the steam engine will start moving. So heat also is a form of energy. Next, interconversion of light energy. Plants usually they will carry out the process of phenomenon of photosynthesis. How photosynthesis is carried out? By absorbing the sunlight. Here light energy is used up by the plants to manufacture their food, and the same food will be stored in the parts of the plant. So light also is a form of energy. Here light energy is converted into chemical energy, right? Yes. If you have a solar cell in your house, then what the solar cell will do? Solar cell will absorb the solar radiation, that is light energy from the sun. So you have a solar cell. From sunlight, it will absorb the radiations, light energy, and it will convert it into electrical energy. So for lighting purposes, we are using this solar energy. Okay. So light energy also can be interconverted. Now, interconversion of sound energy. Suppose you are talking over a microphone, you are speaking over a microphone. Then what is happening? You are converting sound energy into electrical energy. Next question. Microphone, you have a microphone here. You are speaking. A person is standing here and speaking. Sound energy will be converted into electrical energy. Okay. Then, interconversion of magnetic energy. So, you take generators and motors. There, what will be there inside a generator and inside a motor? A magnet will be there. Magnetic energy is used and it can be converted into electrical energy and also mechanical energy. And can you convert electrical energy into various other forms? Yes, every day you are doing. When you light up the bulb, then what you are doing? Electrical energy is converted into light energy. You are running the fan, electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. You are using mixer grinder, electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. You want to lift water from the underground sump, electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. Is it not? So, there is interconversion of electrical energy also. And whether there is interconversion of chemical energy? Yes, chemical energy also we are using. Suppose when you are burning the wood, when you burn wood, what happens? The chemicals present in the wood, the chemicals present in the wood, that is nothing but chemical energy. When you burn the wood, what you are getting? You are getting light energy and also heat energy. There also interconversion of energy is there. So if you consider all these cases, then you can conclude that in our everyday life, we are able to convert energy from one form to the other form. Understood? We are not wasting energy anywhere. Energy is just being converted from one form to the other form. And you are using all the types of, all the forms of energies in our everyday life. Only that we should have a judicious mind. We should make a judicious use of these energy forms. And whenever necessary only, we must convert the energy. Unnecessarily, if you allow the tube light to be on in your room or a fan which is running. Of course, as I told you, there is no wastage of energy. But it is not useful for anybody, is it not? So if you are inside the room and you are using the light and fan, okay. And if it is dark and no air is there, if enough lighting is there, enough air is there, then you have to just conserve the energy for future use. Understood? So this is about the various forms of energy and how energy can be converted from one form to the other form. And all said and done, sun is the main source of energy for all of us. We are using various forms of energy, but which is the primary source of energy? The primary source of energy is the sun only. Suppose if there is no sun, then there is no other form of energy. Understood? The sun is the ultimate source of energy. On earth. Now all of us are surviving only because beings can survive. If you take the formation of coal, then the formation of crude oil, petroleum inside the earth's crust, how it is formed? When the decaying plant and animal matter, when dead and decaying plant and animal matter undergo some chemical changes, then only coal deposits are formed and petroleum deposits are formed. Suppose if sun is not there, then no plant will survive, no animal can survive on the earth. So whatever energy you are getting from coal and petroleum, whether it is mainly due to the sun or not, yes, it is mainly due to the sun. Now due to the sun's energy only, we are able to grow plants, and plants produce their own food, and we are getting food from plants. If sun is not there, you cannot carry out agriculture only, and survival is not at all possible. Even if you take wind, how wind blows, it is mainly due to the energy of the sun. So due to sun's heat energy, light energy, and due to the constant rotation of the earth, the air which is there on the earth, it moves up and gets deflected, and that moving air is called the wind. And we are using wind energy. Wind energy is also used, and it is converted into electrical energy, right? If there is no sun, there is no formation of wind, and there is no harnessing of wind energy, right? And apart from that, if you take other things, hydroelectric, water cycle we have studied, is it not? If there is no sun, then there is no water cycle set up in the nature, because if there is no sun, no evaporation of water will take place from the water bodies. So what happens? There is no water cycle set up, you will not get any rains. If there is no water cycle, no form of life can exist on the earth. So always remember, sun is the ultimate source of energy for all of us on earth. This is all about energy, its various forms, and interconversion of energy. Always remember, the total energy of the system is always conserved. Energy can neither be created, no new energy can be created, neither can be destroyed. But what you can do, children, you can just convert energy from one form to the other form. So this is all about the lesson energy. So I just want you to read the lesson thoroughly, go through the lesson, what all I have done in my previous videos, whether it can be problems on kinetic energy, potential energy, examples, definitions, all these be very thorough, and try to prepare the notes. Understood? If you have any doubts, then when you come back to school, we can always clarify your doubts. Till then, take care of yourself, maintain social distancing, means maintain some 2 meters apart from others, then use sanitizers. Understood? Wear masks, and take care of yourself. Thank you, children.